Yo, what's up, fellas? How you doing? It's your boy Al. Just like that, day after my birthday, boom, start building a layout. Yep. So, just to give you a little rundown of what we're gonna do and what I'm starting today before it all begins, is I was over there, I got wood shavings on me. As you've seen, I got these because I'm gonna be using 1x3s to build my layout. And as you can see, there's a drill, there's a test drills here about, you know, how big I wanna use for these ones. I was thinking like 1 inch is perfectly fine. You know, like 3. First of all, what I'm doing is the layout width is gonna be 2 foot or less. So I got a whole bunch of 2 foot sections cut out. It will be a little bit less, but I have to figure a couple things out. So like, I'm cutting these right now. So the reason why I'm using the 1x3s as opposed to the 2x3s I used to use to build my layout in 2x4s, it's because that's really heavy and I wanna go for a little bit of a lightweight, quicker design. So this will be it right here. I am not a carpenter, so I'm not doing this like 45 degree angles with the spice cuts. I'm just gonna cut basic and do it as I did my last layout and come up with my ideas and things that we know. So as you clearly see there, I chalked the design, right? So you see where it'll come this way and there'll be like a loop that goes around and it will come this way and the loop will go around. It's probably a little bit too tight for that full design. So I don't know if that's gonna work. So that's what I got going on over there. That's my idea. It's not permanent, but one thing is permanent that we know, okay? So the stairs come down. Right now we are standing right around here right now. So one thing that is gonna be the same with all the designs I've done is it's gonna be built along the wall. Of course, you'll see over there, you'll see that the water heater is there, so it will go in front of that, which is right there. That's the circle for the water heater. And then over here is the electrical panel. You can see over there, the electrical panel. So what my plan is as I start tonight, my very first plan is I wanted to do the centralized location on my layout, which will have the TCC system and all other main aspects that I might need, like the cameras and a TV and stuff like that. My new design of the whole benchwork will be quarter inch luan. So that was over there about half inch wafer board. This is quarter inch luan, so it's super, super light. And then on top, you will have this. So this is what it'll look like. So what I'm gonna work on doing right now is I am going to end this part of the video and I'm gonna continue cutting these 2 foot sections because I'm gonna need this and then I'm gonna end up drilling the few holes along a whole bunch of them so that I have them ready. And that will be the support from here to here, you can clearly see. So I'll see you in a few minutes. Let me cut out a few more of these and I'll get back with you as we drill these, all right? See you in a minute. Actually, it's messy, son. I know what you're thinking. I already know, you're watching this video and you're like, is he drilling through the concrete? Probably. Yep, see it right there? Boom, boom, boom. Okay, I have all these cut up to the size that I need. Had these somewhere. This, I don't know how I got these, but they're good for 90 degree angles. This one, move into there. And the reason is, a couple reasons. I'm gonna add some wood glue to that, because what I'm gonna do is be using my, that's what I call it. It's a finish nailer. I'm gonna use these and I'm gonna use 1.5 inch long finish nailers to put this together. So in the meantime, what I'll do is add the wood glue, plug in my finish nailer, corners is nice and tight, let's give this shit a shot. Hope it works. Again, loosen the one section up. Now that it's nice and tight, One thing I forgot to mention, since you know we're working on wood with tools, don't forget your eyewear, safety glasses. I'll get mine at some point. I should have them on now. Anyway, let me finish up this other corner and I'll be back. Okay, so as you can see, quick and easy, I got this here. The pieces here. It's 8 foot section. I'm gonna put 3 supports in the middle. I'm not gonna measure them. I'm just gonna kind of put them up where I think they should go. Finish nailer and throw 3 in. I'll do this 3 more times and then I'll get back with you. I'm not gonna let you watch my video, it's boring. So I'll see you in a minute. Okay, so I have this done, as you can see right here, quick and easy. I have a brad nailer, and I'm gonna use 1¼. Put them on my finish nailer. Now, if I measured this correctly, because I measure, then I go back and see, so I can make mistakes. Happens all the time. I measured this right here to be a little bit wider than 24 inches. The sections that I have here are around 24 inches, but I wanted to leave a little bit of room back there between the edges for track reasons. So if this is correct, this should be a little bit wider. And it is. Look at that. So if you zoomed in, you would see that it's about, I would say, maybe a half an inch wider. So I'm gonna grab my brad nailer after I turn the camera off, and I'm going to attach this all the way around. And be quick and easy, you don't need to watch it. I'll add some glue to the edges and then brad nail around. Take the other section, put it there, do the same exact thing. But literally after I'm done putting up that section and measuring it and installing it, I've actually started my layout, which is kind of cool. I want to make sure I do that tonight before I do anything else. I want to at least install that one section, maybe the second section, and then go from there. All right, so I finally got this all together. One thing I'm using is these construction screws. So I'm gonna be doing this all by myself. I don't have like 6 people helping me like a lot of you guys have. It's just my black ass doing this for myself. So anyway, so what I did was I drilled multiple holes into the end that will go against the wall. And I did it, I was just a little bit smaller, about the same size as a screw. One thing you can notice right here is I had to add a centerpiece in. I made it so it was flush, and then I added these 2 here to hold this in. And the reason why I added this in was I didn't realize that these boards that were 8 foot long are longer than 8 foot sections of Luan. This was actually just an 8 foot section cut out, and it was still about an inch and a half short. So I wanted it so it had continual support. There's like a little 2 1/4 inch gashes in between, no big deal. So right now, let's go on to putting this furthest area over so that I can level it from there. So what I'm gonna do is try to level this. As you see, and I put a whole bunch of screws in here, so it's pre-screwed. And I just want this main section to be above. So that's the difficult thing right there, is how far above and how I get it leveled. Now this is hard being the only guy doing this. Let me get my level so I can finish screwing this in so it's level. See you in a minute. Okay, so finally after 9 months, I have my very first section of layout up. It's official. What I need to do now is put the braces from here down to there. Now like any good experienced, well layout building person, I'd have a nice little angle finder. But let me figure that stuff out. I'll be back. I got work to do. What's up, mother bleepers? So, I knew it would be less than 45 degree angle, but the problem is unless this is, if it's 2 feet by, and 2 feet down, it's 45 degree, 45. But if this is two feet and this is 18 inches down, then the angles are both different. And that's why you have a perfect angle, but I'm not really worried about that. 40 degrees is about right. So what I'm going to do is put these around halfway up over there. So I'm just gonna finish nail them. So the reason why I'm putting them down here and not up here is because I want the mess room right here. And then when I get on top, I'll grab the level. Once I hold it together and level it off, boom. Put four of these up, quick and easy. I just have to do this without busting right through my finger. So, once I see that it's level, which in this end, it needs to come down around there. Boom. Wow, looks good then. So as you can see, this one needs to come up just a tad bit. Right around there. Perfect. That's it. Holds that one section secure until I get this level and I finish them all up. Nail. That was a final nail into me being able to officially say I started my layout. Yeah, son, yeah! Monster Railroad's back, son, yeah! Yo, we're back. Listen, your boy Al is mad excited. I'm very, very excited. Yo, this is sturdy. We're gonna try something at the end of this video. I'll see if it works and then go from there. But anyway, like I said, the whole new way is this Luan, which is lighter in 1x3s. These are the two. These are, I buy these 4x8s, they're $35 a piece. And this is ultimately what's gonna happen, obviously. They will run across the layout like this. And I am officially leaning on my layout. Yo, this is great. I'm officially leaning on Monster Railroad's layout. Some crazy, crazy crap. This is a celebration the day after my birthday. This is a lot of motivation. So with that being said, I guess we don't know how good the benchwork is the way I built it if we don't test it out, right? So as you've seen in my last video when I ended the layout at home, you see what I did at the end of that one, right? Well, let me remind you, check it out right now. No reason to be careful, you know? So you see that video right there? That is how we ended the layout, leaving that old house, that old layout, and that's how we knew it was sturdy. So, yeah, so it holds her, huh? But, since she's obviously lighter than what it's really supposed to be, we have to up the ante, so let's see. Yeah, son, yeah! Yo, this is sturdy, it holds both of us. Your boy Al's back, ready to build a whole new layout. So me and Tiana, see you guys at a rebound, all right?